soomaalidii midowdo saaxiibkii baxayo samatay
nin lagu seexdo waseexan ilbaad seexdaa haseexan nin lagu seexdo waseexan haseexan haseexan soo jeedo
siweynu feejuno soomaalidii midowdo saaxiibkii baxayo samatay soomaalidii midowdo saaxiibkii baxayo samatay
subag weel ku daatay sino maxuumaade subag weel ku daatay sino maxuumaade
waa subag wanaagsan calankana salaama
waa subag wanaagsan
calankana salaama
During the colonial period, modern-day Somalia was split between the British and Italians, while the Ethiopians remained independent. In the late 19th century, the Ethiopians were able to claim Ogaden and Haud, which had a majority Somali population, but they didn't exercise a great deal of authority there. This is how the situation remained until the 1930s, when the Italians invaded Ethiopia. At the end of the Second World War, the Ethiopians achieved their independence again. But the defeated Italians were allowed to maintain control over southern Somalia so long as independence was granted after 10 years. Plus, the British made an agreement with the Ethiopians, reassuring their control over Ogaden, and they would also later be given Eritrea. There were talks of uniting French Somalia, modern-day Djibouti, with the other Somali states, but a referendum was held in the 1950s and this was rejected. Plus, just before the British granted northern Somalia independence, they pulled back on their promise to hand over Kenyan regions to Somalia. So, when the two former colonies united to form the Somali Republic, many ethnic Somalians were living in a foreign country. For the first few years of its existence, the country was run by Aden Abdullah Osman Dar, and he ran the country according to the constitution, becoming the first African leader to democratically hand over power peacefully in 1967. However, his successor was assassinated in 1969, and this allowed the Somali military, led by Siad Barre, to seize power in a coup. General Barre, as a military dictator, began to align himself with the Soviets and the Egyptians, who feared the Ethiopians' control over the Nile River. Meanwhile, in Ethiopia, Emperor Haile Selassie ruled the nations until the 1970s, but the Eritrean War of Independence had erupted, and the population, especially in the northeast, had to endure famines. In 1973, the international oil crisis caused mass inflation and unemployment to skyrocket, and subsequent rebellions allowed the military to oust the emperor and seize power. In this chaos, ethnic Somalis living in Ethiopia formed the Western Somali Liberation Front, and with Somali support, they launched a guerrilla war in 1975. But in 1977, Mengistu took power of the government ruling Ethiopia, known as the Derg, and as a communist, he also began to align himself with the Soviets, and with their support began to clamp down on the guerrillas. He accused Barre of supporting the rebels, but Barre denied these claims. However, sensing the Ethiopians were going to reassert their control over the Ogaden, Barre decided to invade. In mid-July 1977, tens of thousands of Somali troops invaded, and within a couple of weeks quickly occupied the majority of the Ogaden region. Although the Ethiopian Air Force was able to achieve superiority in the air, their land forces were in a poor state. The Soviet Union, meanwhile, was supplying both nations, but decided to only support the Ethiopians after calls for peace failed. They sent aid and advisors to the Ethiopians, and most other communist nations except the Chinese and Romanians agreed to support the Ethiopians. Notably, the Cubans sent tens of thousands of troops to join in the war effort. With their help in mid-August, the Ethiopians were able to repulse an attack on the strategically important city of Dire Dawa. The Somalis were able to capture Jijiga, but Ethiopian air superiority meant their supplies and tanks were targeted, so they could not advance at full capacity. They did, however, try to capture Harar, but they fought a now well-equipped Ethiopian army of 40,000 men, along with Soviet advisors and Cuban troops. The battle lasted for a couple months, but the exhausted Somalis could not resupply and were forced to retreat. They still, however, held most of Ogaden, so they prepared to defend against a counterattack. However, in early 1978, the Ethiopians unexpectedly crossed the highlands east of Jijiga, and their supplies and vehicles were airlifted across the front line. So, they had encircled the Somalis and recaptured Jijiga in March. The now trapped Somalis suffered heavy casualties, so a general retreat was ordered, ending the wars and most hopes of a greater Somalia. Barre lost a great deal of support in the country, and generals from his own Majeerteen clan tried to oust him in a coup after the war. But this failed and Barre remained in power thanks to aid from his new ally, the USA. However, some of the coup leaders fled to Ethiopia and founded the Somali Salvation Democratic Front, and in 1982 they started the short-lived Ethiopian-Somalian border conflict. Meanwhile, over a million ethnic Somalis fled Ethiopia and settled in northern Somalia. Many of these were trained initially to try and reclaim Ogaden again, but instead they were mainly used to suppress members of the Isaac clan. These tensions would eventually lead to a genocide in the late 80s, and in turn the Somali Rebellion, which toppled Barre in 1991. And after Barre fell, a civil war broke out, and this civil war continues today. In Ethiopia, the government were able to crush most of the Somali rebels within their own borders, but some in the Ogaden National Liberation Front continue to fight, and clashed with the government in 2007.